Welcome to the Windows Club. If the character map is not working on your Windows computer, then either read through this article on the website or simply watch this video. I will guide you through the resolutions. The first and the easiest resolution is through the Registry Editor window, which has been explained in solution number 1 of the original article. Press the Windows key and the R button together to open the Run window. In the Run window, type the command REGEDIT and hit enter to open the Registry Editor window. Now go to the path HKCurrentUser control panel input method. In the right pane, we will create a DWR 32-bit entry named enable hex numpad. So right click in the open space, select new DWR 32-bit value and name it enable hex numpad. Double click on it and change the value data to 1. Click on OK to save the settings. The next solution will be to install the latest Windows update. Right click on the start button and select settings from the menu. Go to the Windows update tab on the list on the left hand side. In the right pane, click on check for updates. The third solution will be to troubleshoot in the clean boot state. Press the Windows key and the R button together to open the Run window. In the Run window, type the command msconfig and hit enter to open the system configuration window. In the system configuration window, go to the services tab. Check the box associated with hide all Microsoft services. If any of the services checked, please click on disable all. Finally, select apply and then click on OK to save the settings. You will be prompted to restart your computer and you can click on restart to reboot the system in the clean boot state. After that, you can use the hit and trial method to find the troublesome program. The next solution will be to perform an SFC scan. Search for command prompt in the Windows search bar and click on Run as administrator to open the elevated command prompt window. In the elevated command prompt window, type the command SFC space forward slash scan now and hit enter to invoke the SFC scan. The last solution will be to create a new user profile and login using the same. Right click on the start button and select settings from the menu. Go to the accounts tab on the list on the left hand side. Now scroll down and click on other users. Click on add account. You may not have an account. If you have another account, you can use it. But if you do not, then click on I don't have this person sign in information. You will be prompted to create a new user account and you can create a new user account here. Isn't this easy and interesting? If you have any doubts, please go to the original article on the website, scroll down to the comment section and write your query. We will surely answer to it. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching this video and have a nice day.